Welcome. I will show you how limit of a sum can be calculated by the method of integration. I will suggest you to follow the steps exactly as I am doing, whatever may be the sum. The steps will be as usual. See here, first try to arrange the entire quantities as a symmetric. See, so this one we can write limit n tends to infinity. First one is e to the power 1 by n square plus 2 into e to the power 2 by n square plus 3 into e to the power 3 by n square, and in this way it is going on. But it will, this one is not matching. So you have to match with the same style. So you can write n into e to the power n by n square. Now it is matching with all these things. First step, you have to match the things. Check it if it is matching or not. Now, always follow what I am showing. Limit. First line, take 1 by n common. So what remains? E to the power 1 by n by n. This is, we can say 2 by n, this 1 by n we have taken into 2 by n into e to the power 2 by n. This one also, if you like, you can write in the same style, 1 by n into e to the power 1 by n plus 2 by n. Similarly, here it will be 3 by n into e to the power 3 by n plus, so on, and last one will be n by n into e to the power n by n. So if we are seeing this one, so first term we can say 1 by n and 1 by n. Second term, 2 by n, 2 by n. 3 by n, 3 by n. So, tr equals to what we can say? R by n into e to the power r by n. In different sums, either you can find tr or tr plus 1. That won't matter. Answer will be the same thing. According to situation, you have to calculate either TR or TR plus 1. So here TR is coming this one. Now R by N, instead of R by N, put it at X and write this limit, required limit equals to integration of 0 to 1. Remember, it will be 0 to 1. Instead of R by N, write X, e to the power x dx. Now this integration you are knowing, it is by parts. X is first function into integral of second function. Integral of e to the power x is e to the power x. Minus within integration, derivative of first function is 1 into integral of second function. This one. This whole thing is from 0 to 1, that is equals to x e to the power x minus integral of e to the power x is also e to the power x from 0 to 1. This is because first putting 1, 1 into e to the power 1 minus e to the power 1 minus put 0, 0 into e to the power 0 minus e to the power 0. This is e minus e, this 0
minus 0 and e to the power 0 is 1. So minus of minus 1 equals to plus 1. This is your final answer of this limit. So you have to remember the steps as I have shown.